We're discovering that environments where people used to think they were safe, such as their backyard or perhaps a local community park, were places where they really wouldn't be at risk. What folks don't realize is they may be actually coming into contact with ticks that cause Lyme disease.
About 3 years ago, we began noticing the large number of ticks and wondered why there was a disconnect between the number of cases of Lyme disease that were reported, extremely low, compared to the infection rate in the ticks, which was very high, somewhere around 40% in this area.
About one in every three ticks is carrying the Lyme pathogen in our area. So if you're just walking through and you happen to brush up against some tall grasses or a bush or something that a tick is on and it hops onto you, then unfortunately you might get bitten and you might end up with Lyme disease.
Okay, so these are the most recent results. So basically we're trying to see if the ticks harbor the pathogen that causes Lyme disease. These are basically 96 samples that were assayed. So these represent the positives where there's a band, and you can see that it's about 50% positivity, I would say.
We began to look at some of the environmental factors because from our point of view, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. As we do this research on Lyme disease, it is not only an investigational process meant to help patients and ultimately improve human health, but it's also used as an authentic educational experience for the undergraduate and graduate students here at Binghamton University.
The project began expanding from campus to off-campus in Broome County, Chenango County, and now to a six-county area in and around Broome and Chenango.
Our project is looking at the built environment. So we're looking at areas where people are constantly interacting with their environment, so college campuses, state parks, city parks. Unfortunately, there are still some people that just aren't aware of the risks and the places that you can be at risk. Again, with the common misconceptions, if you don't have the bullseye rash, you don't have Lyme disease, which is not true. If you're hiking in the backcountry, that's the only time you can get infected with Lyme disease. That's not true.
Perhaps the greatest counter to the threat is education. So knowing that you're at risk is really the important side. And our whole venture actually is a public health outcome. That's primarily what we're interested in working towards some sort of mitigation, some sort of public health intervention education strategy.
What I like about the program is that it's so oriented with human health. So you get to kind of see the results from your project. You see who you're helping and how you're helping people. So it's a very rewarding program.
Because it's a problem that is local in scope, it has very complex dynamics, and it's a contribution that we can make here at the university to the folks who live right here in New York State.
It's enormously gratifying to know that we're likely having at least some impact on decreasing the future cases of Lyme in the area.